Kara, this mom told me this story, and she told it to me because she's upset with the reason, the allegation that Jerry Sandusky's attorney has been making, that a lot of these victims knew each other and got together after they heard of one allegation and decided to substantiate the allegation and make more stories up, seeing lawsuits and seeing money coming from Penn State. But she told me this story for that reason, and this is what she said. She said when police came to her in early 2010 and said, you know, we know your son came forward 10 years ago and made an allegation to police and wasn't believed, tell us what happened. She sat down with them and she said, you know, my son had a lot of friends back then. They all hung out together. They all hung out with Jerry Sandusky. And I think you should talk to these other boys too. Not knowing what they would say, she pointed them in these boys' direction, and they were from the pages of that book. They actually she sat down with police, went through the book, and identified several of the victims that ended up being in that grand jury presentment.
So basically, the key to this case was right there on the shelves of the Penn State bookstore.
It's very interesting. A lot of these things were out and obvious. A lot of the keys to this case, because, you know, that's one big break, but the other one was finding that mother, finding victim six's mom. And remember, her name and her phone number was sitting in that police report that was at Penn State Police Barracks that had been closed, and no charges came of it, but it was sitting there in the police barracks for over a year after that victim one came forward, after the police investigation began, before they actually contacted her. So some of the keys to this case were out there, which goes right back to that overriding theme that prosecutors are now talking about, that many people knew something and did nothing.
Sara, before I let you go, you know, a number of former Penn State football players are pushing back against the hiring of Bill O'Brien as the new head coach. How did the search committee come to this decision?
They say that, contrary to reports, it was not a toxic job, that they had a lot of applications, that Bill O'Brien's name was someone, he was someone that they knew of from the beginning, and slowly they just became enamored with him. They really fell in love with him and had nothing to do with being a Penn State guy, but finding someone who had Penn State heart was what they said. And they said that's how they landed on their guy. You know, it seemed like he said all the right things on Saturday when he was introduced, and he did get a loud applause from some Penn State fans, about 100 Penn State fans who showed up for that announcement.